Hey there, everybody. This is Carrie from Soundproofist. Can you hear me? Are you able to hear me right now with the mask on? Okay, great. That's what I thought. So, why then do you think that putting soundproof curtains on your window will help you solve your noise problems? You might have seen some websites or some YouTube videos that recommend these soundproof curtains. Usually they're an Amazon affiliate, and they'll give you a special link to buy them. But if you're dealing with a major noise problem, like cars, trucks, motorcycles, leaf blowers, construction, those are all examples of low-frequency noise. And low-frequency noise goes right through walls and windows. It's like a subwoofer. And it's the very kind of noise that drives you crazy. So, fabric is powerless against low-frequency noise. It's good for sound absorption, but not for soundproofing. If you want to reduce the amount of echo and reverb in a room, that's when you use sound panels, or curtains, or rugs, or felt pads, or foam wedges, but they don't block outside noise from coming in. So let's go over some terminology. You might have seen some products with something called an STC rating. So what's STC? It's a way of rating the amount of soundproofing or the effectiveness of the soundproofing in a material. It tells you how many decibels are reduced by the materials in your walls or in your window. Then you can figure out how many decibels will pass through to the other side. STC is actually an acronym for sound transmission class. So let's say there's a construction project in front of your house. You go outside with your decibel reader and the noise measures at 100 decibels. Inside, with all of your windows closed, let's say the noise measures at 70 decibels. The difference between the two is the STC, which would be about 30, and which is in the range of a double-pane window. A typical single-pane glass window has an STC rating of about 20 to 26. If you have double-pane windows, you might get an STC rating from 27 to 35. And getting that higher number, the 35, might mean spending some extra money to put a special laminate on the glass. So even with the double pane windows, you're still going to get noise passing through, especially low frequency noise. And the performance of your windows also depends on your wall assembly. For example, if you live in a wood frame building and your walls are like thin sheetrock nailed directly on the wood framing, it's going to pass a lot of low frequency noise through. And it might also depend on insulation and how well your windows were sealed. And yes, some companies make custom-fit plexiglass window inserts. You fit them onto your windowsill in front of your existing window. They say these inserts will increase the STC up to 45 if you use them along with a double-pane window. I haven't personally tried them yet because of the cost. One large window insert might be $1,000 or more, and a smaller window, maybe 48 inches high by 36 inches wide, it might be about $600. And you can't just do one window in a room, you need to do all of them. So what can you do? If you have the budget, consider buying professionally made window inserts. Personally, I have storm window inserts made of vinyl. And they reduce some noise, a little bit, by about 4 decibels. But they don't have enough density or mass to block serious low-frequency noise. You also need to make sure that your walls have enough soundproofing. Another option you might consider is to build your own plexiglass window inserts. But they need to fit really well inside your window frame. I know you wish there was an easy and affordable solution, and I do too. But it's not curtains. So in summary, the outside noise that bothers you the most is low-frequency noise, which penetrates walls and windows. The best way to reduce low-frequency noise is to add more mass and separation, because a lot of noise is actually vibration, and vibration is caused by contact. Double-pane glass is better than single-pane glass, and if you can afford it, plexiglass window inserts are even better. And finally, take a look at your wall assembly, the insulation, and the seals around your windows to see if they're contributing to the noise issue. You can find more information on noise and acoustics at soundproofist.com.